music this afternoon is the University of Texas Longhorn Commencement Brass. You took the courses, ran for the finals, left your way through the term papers, multiple guest 100 exams, flirted with a co-ed next to you, drank too much beer on one occasion, made a bad film before you made a good film, somehow got on the staff at the Daily Texan, visited the career services yesterday, watch Longhorn football, harass the TAs and schmooze the faculty. But now you're really, really good at being a college student. Today, you're a professional. Tomorrow, you'll be an amateur once again. Tomorrow will be like the first time you set foot on the 48ers. Tomorrow, you're going to have to learn something new. And learning something new is a colossal pain. There's something inside each of us that wishes the world would stand still so we can stay at UT forever, never leave our friends, eat at the same low-down restaurant every day, change your sheets only when required by the health department. In one way or another, all of us are conservatives. But life is not a conservative. Life is a liberal. It refuses to conserve. Life insists on being ever new, ever challenging, throwing curveball after changeup after slider, just so you don't get comfortable standing near the plate. Life produces new software, just when you become familiar with the old software. Life gives you a new boss, who's far more demanding than the old boss. Life caused your car to break down on I-35. Life gets you pregnant at just the wrong time. Life keeps you guessing. Inevitably, life also keeps you learning. Much of what you know today will be irrelevant 5 years from now. The cochlear implant technologies you studied in the speech and hearing clinic will change next year. The animation sequences you learned in the film lab may already look passe to your kid brother. The advertising layouts you mastered will seem oddly provincial when you transfer to the one office. Today you're hip, cool, contemporary, radical, cutting edge. But trust me on this, there's a dinosaur lurking inside each and every one of you. And that's where UT comes in. UT has taught you how to learn. UT is your ace in the hole, your way of staving off your problems. UT is your partner for life, constantly goading you to do more and to learn more and to be more and to hate mediocrity. UT has taught you that reading something important is better than watching something happen. UT has taught you to hate stupidity above all else. UT has given you an instinct for growing, for getting another degree, for leaving a job that bores you, for refusing to waste time, for taking a short course that's not required, for making a new friend every 48 hours. At its best, UT has made you restless. My prayer for you today is that you will stay restless each and every day for the rest of your life. Amen. At this time, I wish to introduce the faculty marshals for the department, Professor John Murphy from the Department of Advertising and Public Relations, who is our grand marshal. Professors Courtney Bird and Tom Harper, Department of Communication Science and Disorders. Professor Anthony Dudo and Brad Love, Department of Advertising and Public Relations. Yeah. presses Don Howard and Tom Schatzman, our radio television bell. Presses Josh Bond and Terry Stevenson, Department of Communication Studies. Presses Hamar, Merrill, Dale Zernigut, and Kevin Roberts from the School of Journalism. On the stage, key members of our academic and student affairs areas and special guests, Dr. Steve Reese, Associate Dean of Academic Affairs. Dr. Mark Bernstein, Associate Dean of Student Affairs. Mr. Darrell Roach, Assistant Dean of Student Affairs. Dr. Dave Chunker, Lecturer in the Department of Advertising and Public Relations. Exaggeration to say that an academic institution is no stronger than the strength of its faculty. We're blessed to have a faculty who love working with young people as much as they love working with ideas. I'd like to ask the faculty to stand and be recognized. I'd also like to acknowledge the advisory and support staff of the Office of Student Affairs. These wonderful people play an indispensable role in the lives of our students during their academic careers. We're especially indebted to the OSA staff for coordinating our graduation ceremony this afternoon. I'd now like to introduce the President of the College of Communication Student Council, Mr. Bobby Hanson. Bobby is from Houston, Texas, is majoring in RTF and Public Relations. Over his years at UT, he has participated in the University Filmmakers Alliance, Texas Yearbook, Texas Running Club, the Music and Entertainment Committee, and the Student Events Center. He served on the Common Council for the past 4 years. Most days he can be found in the Council's office in the Mobile, Texas, New York. Bobby will be joining Elements, New York, this evening. Pleased to present to you, Mr. Bobby Hamilton.
And isn't that the core component of our craft as communication professionals? The the mastery of how we say it. This is our eternal pursuit. In journalism, we look for ways to be impactful with groundbreaking stories. In advertising and public relations, we seek sources of inspiration and attract consumers to a brand or a cause. In radio, television, film, we find new ways of visually telling stories of those normally unseen and unheard. In communication sciences and disorders, we open the doors of communication, both verbally and non-verbally. And in communication studies, we work at developing the best methods of reaching audiences. Honing your craft is an individual effort that only you can determine. Don't ever allow anyone to determine or criticize your path, your career, or your life. The craft is yours and yours alone. On individuality and pursuing inner callings, I refer to an excerpt of Steve Jobs' commencement address to Stanford University in 2005. Steve Jobs dedicated his life and craft to the advancement of technology, and he proved to be a master craftsman, not only the products he created, but also his genius approach to relating and communicating with people. I believe his following words are crucial for every graduate as we pursue our own individual craft. He said, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living the results of other people's thinking. And don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. Stay hungry, stay foolish." And to that, I would like to add, stay fearless and unapologetic as you pursue your craft. On behalf of the graduates today, I'd like to extend a heartfelt thank you to all the friends and family who have traveled this weekend to be with us today. Thank you for your support, both emotionally and financially, throughout our education. Additionally, I'd like to thank all the faculty and staff of the College of Communication for providing us with such a wonderful education. The knowledge we have gained and the opportunities we've experienced are truly a gift, and we are most grateful. I am certain that we, the graduates of the 2013 class of the College of Communication, will always still stay hungry and have the inner drive to continue along our individual journeys of pursuing our calling and owning our craft. Congratulations to the class of